she completely burst my balloon by telling me that, look, all this stuff doesn't impress me. What I like about you is just you, just be yourself. I mean, my all-time favorite movie was Deewar. My dream is that in my lifetime, we can overcome poverty in Odisha. For the first dozen years, I was very proud of what BJD stood for. It stood against gundaism, it stood against corruption. When the BJD changed in the last 5 years, there is increasing corruption in Odisha. It's all there in the record. Speaking out internally didn't work. I started speaking out externally. Then I was being treated very shabbily in the party.
The Jay Panda people do not know. And from Vijayant Panda to Jay Panda.
I think more and more people are beginning to know that I'm an avid writer and a reader. I read about 50 books a year.
Okay.
And I have a separate Twitter handle sharing my reading, and that has more than 1,000 followers. So more and more people are beginning to know that. I've always been a very avid reader. And right from college days, I picked up the habit of audiobooks. Originally, it used to be on cassettes, then on CDs. Then you could download files on the computer.
Both of you decided, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm treading personal ground, not to have children because you had busy careers.
You know, we both grew up with very loving families. And we both had careers that were very busy. And yes, you're right, we discussed and we decided that there are lots of children in the world. Mm. And perhaps we should adopt rather than having children. Mm. So we've done partially, we've met that goal. We haven't got around to adopting, but what she has done, mostly Jaggi, and we both have, is that we have adopted an orphanage.
Okay.
And we support it. In fact, two. We support two orphanages. I was quite stunned that somebody from the glamour world was such a grounded, rooted person. She was educated. So that was something that helped to completely sweep me off my feet. So I tried the usual routine. I remember in New York hiring a limousine and lots of flowers, taking her to a very famous restaurant. At the end of it, I went through all that thinking I was having an effect on her, but she completely burst my balloon by telling me that, look, all this stuff doesn't impress me. What I like about you is just you, just be yourself. I don't need all this fancy wooing. And that was amazing. She found me to be genuine, to be straightforward, to not have... She told me that I liked the fact that I was not arrogant.
Are you a film buff?
I used to be, but I don't have the time much anymore. So I grew up in the India of the 70s, so I loved the Bollywood movies of the 70s.
Tell me about those. Who are your favorites?
I mean, my all-time favorite movie was Deewar.
Okay.
And in Bollywood. But I also like movies like Golmaal, the original Golmaal with Amol Palekar.
What are your personal dreams?
So my personal dream is, because I have been involved in politics and I'm from Odisha, although Odisha has been developing gradually, but it's still far behind the national average. My dream is that in my lifetime, we can overcome poverty in Odisha. We have 4 million Odias working outside, some of them in war zones like Iraq and Afghanistan, because there are no jobs in Odisha. I want to change that. I want to have jobs available for these Odias. I was a very proud member of BJD. You will remember the early days when I used to fight for building up the BJD.
That's
and
right.
Defending
That's
it
right.
in Delhi, when people used to write it off as a flash in the pan. For the first dozen years, I was very proud of what BJD stood for. It stood against gundaism, it stood against corruption. I quit because first I tried, when the BJD changed in the last 5 years, there's a new coterie that has taken control of the party leadership.
You've spoken about that.
I've spoken about it.
What about BJP?
There is increasing crime in Odisha. There is increasing corruption in Odisha. It's all there in the record. Now, when speaking out internally didn't work, I started speaking out externally. Then I was being treated very shabbily in the party.
Finally, Mao, I see this picture. And are you a follower? Are you an admirer?
You'll also see a bust of Buddha.
I did see that. Very beautiful.
So people ask me that, how come you have a bust of Buddha? Hmm. How come you have a picture of Mao? Now, I urge you to look at it very carefully. Hmm. So if you look at the Mao painting, there is something unusual about it. It is Mao holding a Louis Vuitton bag.
Yes.
Now, this is painted by a sort of a rebel artist in Singapore who makes this very ironic drawing that China of today is not Mao's China. The front of it may be Mao,
but
the front of it may be that it's a communist state, but behind his back, he's holding a very expensive luxury bag, that there's something in the front and the reality is something different. So that's the irony that I'm trying to protect. No, I don't believe in Maoism at all. I'm just using that to show the
irony. Okay, what about Buddha?
I very much admire the Buddha. I think Buddhist principles are something that have had a great impact around the world.
One last question. You listen to the piano and you don't play
it. I don't play any musical instrument.
Hmm.
But
Jaggi plays the piano?
Jaggi plays a little bit.
So she plays and you listen.
Well, we have lots of other friends who are very advanced players. So when we have soirees in the evenings, some friend will play the piano.
Okay.
And it's wonderful to have that.